Now, when using tomato, very often the recipe asks you to peel the tomato, seed the tomato. You can peel it in many different ways. This one, you impale on a fork or on a knife like that, right above the gas stove, and it will burn and char the skin, which, as you can see, after that slide out very easily. And it also imparts a little bit of taste to the tomato. The most common way is probably to put it in boiling water, like I have here. How long do you leave it? Depending if the tomato is really ripe, like 10 seconds. If it's not too ripe, a bit longer. Often people choke it in cold water after. I don't really do it. I think it kind of tends to taste some taste out of it. Now you can do it with a knife as well, especially if you intend to keep the skin for one reason or another. For example, here with the knife, I will my knife in a jigsaw fashion. I go this way, I make a base, and I will turn around, and you can see my knife is moving up and down. I'm sawing like in a jigsaw fashion. I'm doing one streak here, I'm going one peel, and I stop the peel here, and I'm doing a second peel to add to it. If I do this, it's because I want to use this as a flour. So the base is there. I can put that right on the base. See, it will hold nicely. And then with this one, and you can see the edge, because I'm sewing it around, I do a very tight scroll out of this. And that tight scroll, I will, of course, place in the center of my tomato here to finish the rose. Here we are. Actually, I could have used also a vegetable peeler, and you can see here those vegetable peelers work absolutely wonderful for that. This is a serrated edge vegetable peeler, and it works very well. So when you have a tomato like this, very often recipe asks you to seed it, you should cut it across. That is perpendicular to the stem, across, and then you press out the seed and the juice. All of that you keep for stock. When I have a nice tomato which is ripe like that, I could take a piece of this. I take a clean towel, put that in the middle of it, and I can do my own cherry tomato. Any size that I want. And then you can open it, of course. You have a nice bowl of tomato here. And you can put them on a little skillet, brush it with a little bit of butter, dash of salt, warm it up to serve it as a garnish, you know, for one fish or another. The rest of the tomato is usually cut into dice like this and sauté in what we call a concassé of tomato.